All right, so in this demo, I'm going to show you basically what I've built very quickly for the hackathon. It's built on top of an existing solution, which is basically an intranet management tool built in SharePoint and with Power Automate. So if we keep going here, just the quick agenda about me, why I created this, how it was built, and I want to focus mainly on the demo here. So about me, my name is Gissur Simonarson. I'm the co-founder and CTO of Cloud Sherpa. I'm an Icelander living in Scotland. I've lived in the US as well and in Norway, so done a lot of work in a lot of different countries. 25 years experience in enterprise solution architecture and development. It's always weird for me to say, it feels way too much. And then just my LinkedIn here in case anybody wants to connect. So why I created this solution. So, you know, like I said, I've been doing this kind of enterprise solution architecture for a long time and have always preferred kind of pro code ways of doing things. And most of these solutions have been built around SharePoint and kind of the Microsoft ecosystem. But, you know, I would say like the past 4 years, I've been radicalized into low code solutions. Especially, you know, I've been working for a lot of large organizations, specifically right now, and they're paying, you know, outrageous fees for licensing for, you know, third-party software and things like that. So what I've been doing with Power Automate and SharePoint recently is basically taking some of their existing third-party solutions, bringing them into SharePoint, using Power Automate, kind of all low code, so it's easier for them to, you know, manage. It's cheaper. And also one big thing is it's less platforms for users to deal with. So it's just the M365 platform versus a bunch of third parties that are all over the place. And if you have solutions built in M365, especially now with Copilot, it makes AI integrations super easy. So that's kind of the genesis of where all this came from. And, you know, how it was built, basically SharePoint is what I would say like the database for the solution. Power Automate is the brains and does all the work behind the scenes. And then I have, you know, layered Copilot Studio on top of it to do some actions. And, you know, that was one of the big things that I wanted to do with this demo is make Copilot not just answer questions, but actually do things for the user, right? So let's have a look. So let me move this out of the way. And so what I built is basically, so we have the education hub, and that is to teach users, you know, how to use the internet, how to use SharePoint, how to use Stream, Viva Engage, kind of all the M365 tools. And then I also built this intranet hub. And what you can do here is you can, you know, request new SharePoint sites. You can pick site templates that you want to use, you know, intranet hub, topic, or video site. But what I wanted to do is kind of integrate this with AI. So first, so I built this a few months back. So back then, you couldn't deploy Copilot Studio bots into the SharePoint Copilot. So I had to bring it in using, you know, SPFx web part, and that's the reason we have this interface. But, you know, let's start out first just with the education hub. So how do I embed videos in SharePoint? And this is kind of the standard, you know, easy AI thing. So it basically just looks at this education hub site, finds the article related to how to embed videos, and will give you kind of a step-by-step entering edit mode. And what's nice about this when it's hovering like this is you can then click on here and you'll get to that specific page and you can go ahead and read that, right? But what I really was interested in is getting it to create sites for us and do different actions. So first, let's say, you know, create a site for me. And it'll say, what's the name? Live M365 community demo. Which template, intranet hub, primary owner, I put myself, and secondary owner like this. And it will now go ahead, and I'll show you guys how all this works in the background, right? So now it says your site with Intranet Hub is being created. So now what I can also go and say is, what's the status of the site? And it will say that the live M360 community demo is currently in progress. So how this works is we have our Intranet Hub site here, and it has some SharePoint lists, right? So up here is site requests. And the site request list, you know, basically adds now this live M365 community demo. You can see it's in progress here. And this then gets picked up by Power Automate. Power Automate goes, creates the site. It then looks for, you know, what template you're using. It finds that template site. So I can show you guys, hold on, I got to move my camera a bit here. So this is kind of the template that I have selected here. So this is the URL for that template site. So it'll use this template when it's creating the new site. And then once that's all done, it'll go back and write to the site directory. So we have a site directory here for all the created sites, and it'll appear here once it's done. And what's nice about this is this kind of brings all the, you know, SharePoint Admin Center information for the intranet admins to be able to view without having SharePoint admin access. So it gives a little more information here. Now, if we go into the agent itself, and what's nice about, you know, Copilot plus Power Automate is you can create tools using Power Automate, and that's how all this has been done. So, you know, it's pretty standard, just, you know, simple instructions for what it's all about. If we go into the tools here, you'll see I have the create site with Copilot tool and get site status tool. I have a third one that I'll show you in a little bit, and that's to set out of office. And it's just kind of, you know, I want to, again, see how we can do a bunch of different actions within an agent for the user to make kind of their day-to-day digital experience better. And I'll also show you guys why I have not enabled it here. I've basically had to bring it into a topic because of date formatting. I wasn't able to kind of take date formatting very well directly into a tool like this. Now, let me move my camera, sorry. I have it blocking my screen. So if we have a look, so I have basically the different Power Automates here. So this is the Intranet Site Creator Power Automate. I'm not gonna go into those. They're kind of big and clunky. I then have an Intranet Site Configuration. So basically it creates a site and then it configures it. And the reason for that is because I also want you to be able to create the sites using the normal SharePoint UI. So it comes as a site design, and then this will kick off just on the site design itself. So we'll close these, but if we now have a look at, you know, create site with Copilot, and because this is all created, you know, the intranet provisioning engine is created using Power Automate and SharePoint, this becomes super easy, right? All we need to do is create an item on that intranet hub on the site request list. And it takes in, you know, site name, site template, primary and secondary owner. And what's nice about this, right, is when you use these kinds of tools, if I go back here and I just say, you know, I just want to write it all in one, I can say, create a new site called All in One Demo Live. With the template intranet hub, primary owner, and secondary owner. So, you know, instead of having to go step by step, you can write it all in one and it'll go away and create that as well. So, you know, when you use Power Automate as a tool like this, it makes things super simple and quick to do, right? So it's just creating one list item and then another Power Automate picks that up for you. The, you know, checking the site status, another very simple one, right? It is, it just gets items from that list and I just say title equals site title. And then it responds with the status. The last bit here is, so first of all, I just got the first site created, so we can just have a quick look at it. So we can see here, live community demo has been created. And let me click here. And you can see the site has been set up with that template that I showed you earlier. And, you know, it activates a bunch of different applications on there to get that green line underneath, you know, the headers. So it does a lot of configurations to the site just using Power Automate, which is super cool. And, you know, basically allows you to build this kind of SharePoint orchestration engine in a pretty easy way. The last bit I wanted to show here, and I'm just realizing that I think I still have my out of office on. So let me turn that off. So if we have a look at my Teams here. Let me see. Sorry, this camera is messing with me. So I'm not out of office here. And let me just look at my activity so that we can see it here in the So if you watch down here as I interact with the agent, I can say set my out of office. And it'll say, what's the start date? I'll say today. And what's the end date? Tomorrow. And so now as I hit enter here, if you watch the icon here, it should quickly, oh, sorry, the message. I am doing a live demo. And you can see now my out of office is set. And if we have a look in here, we can see I'm doing a live demo has been set as my out of office. So this one was a little bit trickier just because of date formatting. So the way I did this is I created a topic called out of office. And, you know, it basically identifies a date and makes it into a date, you know, object here in the question, then gets the message you want, and then sends that to the Power Automate action with a message, the two dates. And then obviously that Power Automate is just setting the out of office. So yeah, just a real quick demo for you guys. I know I've gone pretty fast here. I'm looking at my time. I think I have some time left, but I think that's it. But if you guys have any questions, be happy to answer.